a project like this, and then we will focus on sustainable taxiing and obviously the taxibot test that's currently going on at Schiphol Airport. So the broader picture, sustainable taxiing is part of what we call the tow-only airport. And that is a project name, which means that we have the ambition to move all aircraft from A to B. So that means from gate to runway or runway to gate with autonomous zero emission devices. And well, the question is why so difficult? Why not just do sustainable taxiing, talk about sustainable taxiing and well, finish there. The reason for that is that what we see as an airport, and many airports have the same problems, we see that we are very much congested, growing very fast, usually old airports. And we see that we are more and more capacity constrained at the airport. And while being so, safety is under an increasing pressure. And safety and capacity are a very delicate balance that I think most airports are involved with. Now, if we add to that delicate balance sustainable taxiing, we also add more complexity and different processes to the airport. And whether we would like it or not, processes that are usually done at a certain location will be performed somewhere else. Maybe they go faster, they go slower. Everything changes. We will get back to that later on in our part of the taxibot. But then sustainable taxiing is actually influencing the delicate balance within the airport. And therefore, it's important not to only to look at sustainable taxiing itself, but also to look at the safety and capacity in order to have an integral solution for the airport. And what we see is that there are three enablers, the three key enablers for change that enable this project to work out. And the first one, obviously, sustainability, which we will talk elaborately on today. The second one is more or less about capacity. It's called ASMGCS, Advanced Service Movement Guidance and Control Systems, very long abbreviation. But what it's about planning and routing aircraft, like your navigation in your car, which increases the capacity of the airport and increases the safety of the airport. It's a European project making this happen. And what we see another enabler is the so-called apron management service provider, an AMSP, which is very similar to an ANSP with the November, an air navigation service provider like LVNL in the Netherlands, air traffic control, so to say. And what an apron management service provider does, it arranges all traffic on the ground. It's actually ATC on the ground. And that enables us to perform all these tasks in an integral way. But these two latter subjects are more something for another time, or if you want to follow our blogs on LinkedIn. Today we will talk about sustainability, and we will start about that in this slide. If you can press another time, please, then the picture will also show. Yes, very nice. Thank you. Sustainable taxiing. So that is one of the parts of this complete project, and is what we are talking about today. Sustainable taxiing is actually the art of moving an aircraft from A to B without the aircraft having to use its own engines. And the problem is aircraft engines are made to fly. So on the ground, they use a lot of fuel compared to what the task they're actually being assigned to. So it's more efficient to do it, to do this movement with, for instance, electrical engines. So if you do that, what would be the benefit? For Schiphol, we calculated that we would save around 26 million kilograms or 31 million liters of kerosene a year at the airport. And that's about 80,000 tons of CO2. It's obviously not the only thing we are looking at. We are also looking at CO, ultrafine particles, noise, things like that. So if we summarize the reductions, we would be somewhere between 50 and 85% in reduction of all these factors such as noise, ultrafine particles, and things like that. And that's because the kerosene usage will be around 50 to 85% reduced. So there are two things to say about this. First one is why the range? Why not just say this is it on average and we are ready? The reason for that is actually that we have calculated at Schiphol before the trials with taxibot that it would be 50%. And one of the more positive calculations were 85. So that's why we were trying to calculate within the taxibot test what it really, really is. And it seems to be right in between around 70 to 75%. And the reason why it's not 100%, that's the other interesting fact about this one, is explained on the picture on the right. On conventional taxiing, you see that 98% of all fuel used during taxiing is used by the aircraft engines. And obviously, if you turn down the aircraft engines, that will decrease. But the problem with aircraft engines, and you see that in the second line, is that they have to warm up and cool down as well before takeoff, 3 minutes of warming up, around 3 minutes, depending on the weather, engine type, etc. And on arrival, they have to cool down again as well, also around 3 minutes. So you will never reach the 100% reduction we are looking for. And in addition to that, also the APU will be running during the electrical or sustainable taxiing. So that will also be a little bit of kerosene usage. So we won't get rid of all of it, but we will make huge steps, as we have proved here in Amsterdam already. And very short about how to do it. You can do sustainable taxiing generally in two ways. First one is a so-called aircraft-based system, also called onboard system. It's usually an electrical engine placed in the landing gear for wheel tuck, that's in the nose gear of the aircraft. For EGTS, it was because they stopped in the main gear of the aircraft. And then the electrical engine moves the aircraft around, forward and backwards, powered by the APU of the aircraft. Well, the positive side of these technologies are that you can use it at outstations. So after you have departed, you take it with you. And if you land at an outstation, you can also use it and save fuel over there. The negative part, obviously, is that you have to take it with you. And with that, you will use additional fuel, around 3 to 4% additional fuel per kilogram per hour. So that's quite a lot. So that's why these solutions are less efficient for longer flights. That about the aircraft-based systems. Wheeltuck is the only one in development at the moment, but not certified yet. They are trying to be certified next year. And then on the other hand, there is the airport-based systems. They stay on the airport, so the advantages and disadvantages are the other way around. Then we have the TaxiBot. It's the only certified solution in the world for towing aircraft to the runway on high speeds without restrictions. And we also have in development ATS, the aircraft towing system, which is a concept still, where aircraft are being towed to the runway by a rail system. But obviously, we will talk about TaxiBot, as we this is the only certified solution in the world, and we use it at Schiphol at the moment. So Dirk will tell something about that in the next slide, in a nice movie we have made about the TaxiBot.
We hebben hier op Schiphol een nieuw en innovatief voertuig, de TaxiBot, waarmee we een proef aan het uitvoeren zijn om vliegtuigen duurzaam te kunnen laten taxiën. Dat wil zoveel zeggen als dat we vliegtuigen van de gate naar de startbaan kunnen brengen zonder het gebruik van hun eigen vliegtuigmotoren. De normale pushback tracker koppelt los na de zogenaamde pushback, het achteruitduwen van een vliegtuig. Dit voertuig blijft aangekoppeld staan tot de positie zo dicht mogelijk bij de startbaan, zodat het vliegtuig de motoren op zo'n laat mogelijk moment in het proces kan starten. We besparen tijdens het proces van gate naar startbaan 50 tot 85% brandstof en daarmee wordt de uitstoot ook gereduceerd. Dit voertuig kan, ten opzichte van een normale pushback tracker die maar tweewielbesturing heeft, met zijn vierwielige besturing zowel onze as draaien als zijbaan rijden. Dit zorgt ervoor dat de piloot vanuit de cockpit kan sturen met zijn neuswiel, waarmee de bewegingen volledig worden gekopieerd naar de bewegingen die dit apparaat maakt. Taxiën gaat vrij snel. In de luchtvaart spreken we van knopen. Het zijn 22 knopen. Dat is een krappe 50 km per uur. Het is nu nog een proef, maar we hopen uiteindelijk dat we in de operatie op Schiphol proces met een dergelijk voertuig ook grootschalig kunnen gaan toepassen.
Well, that was basically what the introduction of the TaxiBot here in Amsterdam Airport, Schiphol, is. The thing is, as an airport, we've seen a natural role as a leader in guiding the way towards the future in terms of airport-based systems. Like Simon already mentioned, the aircraft-based systems. When an airline decides to come to Amsterdam with an aircraft-based solution, obviously we are more than welcome to have them here, and we can facilitate this in procedures. But in an airport-based solution, we can lead the way, and it's along with what Robin already mentioned. It is that in a close collaboration with a lot of stakeholders, we've been able to at least start trials using the taxibot here. It will be here, it will remain here until the 14th of August. And we've done all sorts of tests from night tests to de-icing tests towards the actual fuel saving noise measurements. So in the first bullets, what you can see is already, which is basically the technical data specs of the current taxibot as it is available for here in Amsterdam, 54% of the flights. It is still powered by a diesel electric drivetrain, but we might be able to electrify this in the near future. The way it works is basically the pushback is the same as there is in the current situation, but without a turning angle between the aircraft and the tow truck. So the taxibot stays in line with the aircraft all the time. So it can make basically a direct movement because it steers with all its wheels. And after the pushback, the driver sets the taxibot into pilot mode, after which the pilot controls the taxibot. Well, what you could basically do is have an integrated pushback and taxi out call because there's no engine startup or engine warm-up time in the meanwhile. So we can clear our apron base very fast. This is one of the advantages that we do see when taxiboting from a capacity perspective. For the proof of concept, we chose to do the normal way around. So we still have a pushback clearance given by ATC, after which the pilot calls for a taxi clearance. Basically, taxibot is working like a car with an automatic drivetrain. So when the aircraft or the pilot releases his brakes, the taxibot will start to drive up till a set speed, which we mapped the whole airport in the speed metrics. So we're able in these terms in quantifying speeds, cornering speeds, accelerating speeds, decelerating speeds, in order to see what we can and what we can improve still in the whole process. But in the same time, when taxiboting or pull aircraft towards runways, what we do see is that we face a lot of challenges still. In the proof of concept, you might have seen it in the video already. We're working close collaboration with a lot of parties involved. In the Netherlands, the Ministry of the Infrastructure and Water Management is a close call. And we have the airlines, Corendon, KLM, and Transavia involved, and the handlers, Denata, and KLM Ground Service as well. Whereas ATC is another very important actor in the whole process. And what we do see, and this is why Simon mentioned the AMSP already, is just in the current operational concept, as an airport, we basically more or less take over a role which used to be taken care of by the ground handlers. But at the same time, the taxiing process is still a flight process of the aircraft where an airline is in charge again. So there's a need for a whole new spectrum of working together in close collaboration. And this is what we basically see here at the airport. So in terms of fuel savings and emission savings, we do see that that we can keep up to the promise. But in order to scale up largely, we strive to have a large implementation by 2030. We do see challenges on both process, infrastructure, and technical aspects. As we're an organically grown airport, you can imagine that the space at the airport is limited, whereas the taxibot dimensions, it's just a very large truck pushing and pulling a medium-sized aircraft. So our aircraft stands cannot always accommodate the taxibot. On the other hand, handlers need to adjust their process. We do have handlers driving the taxi bot. They're still necessary in order to get the taxi bots driven back towards its origin. And we also go to a new uncoupling point where we have the aircraft get back into the usual taxi system towards the last part of the taxiing part towards the runway. So basically what we do see is that there's a need for a new search of way of working closely together. And for us in the short term, this is, we've proven this by our proof of concept already, but we do see ample challenges in the next few years in order to scale up.
Yeah, so how to get from the point where we are now to a full-scale operation in 2030, which is the goal to have the sustainable taxiing as standardized process at Schiphol Airport in 2030. So how to get there with the challenges we have? First of all, we will finish up a feasibility study with the whole sector, the whole aviation sector, so the airlines, the handlers, the air traffic control in the airport. It's very important to get all the stakeholders on the same page on where we are now and where we want to go with each other. So we spend a lot of time doing this. I think it's actually the key of what we're doing over here. 2021, we expect some autonomous experiments and not only on technology side, but also regulation side. We want to do the sustainable taxiing with autonomous technology, but the technology and the regulations are not ready yet, so we have to work on that as well. And in 2022 we hope to participate in the CESAR Perfect Flight, which could lead to Schiphol having additional taxi bots again, and hopefully with a first implementation of the technology at the airport to use, not in a test setting but in an operational setting. And after 2022, we could slowly move towards the development of the TOW-only airport. But this is all very premature, as the feasibility study is not ready yet. So we have to be a little bit careful with these kind of roadmaps. But this is the idea globally. And I think we are long overdue. So Christian, I think the floor is yours now.